Hey guys, I'm Hannah Roberts. Thanks for checking out this video. If you find it useful, please drop me a like and also subscribe. But getting into it, as you can tell from the title, I'm going to be talking about my low poundage arrow setup. This is the arrow setup that I use for hunting, and for reference, I shoot 50 pounds and I have a 26 inch draw length. Just a quick overview of the arrow before diving in too deep is I shoot a Black Eagle X Impact 500 spine micro diameter arrow. I shoot tack vanes in a four fletch configuration along with a lighted nock. I have a 48 grain outsert along with a 125 grain S-series iron will broadhead. As I said before, I shoot a micro diameter arrow. I decided to go with this arrow because whenever I was doing research, it showed that they had more penetration compared to a larger shaft. And with me shooting a low poundage bow, I definitely need all the penetration that I can get. If you think about it, if you're outside in the yard and you have a toothpick and a stick and you try to poke both of those into the ground, the toothpick is going to go into the ground more easily because it has less surface area. And with that comes less wind. And we were in Illinois last week and we were hunting in 16 miles per hour wind one day. And if an opportunity arose where I needed to take a shot in those conditions, I need to be confident in my arrow setup that it's going to be unaffected by the wind. Also, micro diameter arrows maintain their speed more, and here in Alabama, our deer can be a little spookish, and we just want to make sure my arrow is getting there before they have time to react to my arrow. And this is why I chose a micro diameter arrow. All right, moving on to my fletchings. I decided to go with tack vanes because they are a stiffer vane, and I feel like whenever they're passing through a deer, instead of being super weak and flimsy, they are just taking everything with it that they hit. I also decided to go with a four fletch because I had better groupings compared to a three fletch. I feel that the four fletch steadied my arrow and made it fly more true. Not saying that you need to do a four fletch. I think the best thing for you to do would be to fletch a three and a four fletched arrow and shoot both and just see which one you shoot better and see which arrow performs better with that fletching configuration. Moving on from my fletchings, let's move to my nock. I decided to go with a lighted nocturnal because it makes it easier for me to see where I hit the deer since it is lit up. Also, if I shoot a deer in the evening and we go back to track it that night, it's easier to find my arrow because it is lit up. Also, we film our hunts, and so I like the fact that you can see the arrow flying through on video because it's lit up again. But a nocturnal is heavier than a normal nock, so just be sure that you get enough where you can have some on your practice arrows as well. Now moving on to the front of my arrow, I decided to go with a 48 grain outsert because not only does it help add weight to the front center of my arrow, it protects my arrow in case I hit something hard so it's not going to splinter or break. Moving on to what I believe is the most important part of my arrow setup, which is my broadhead. I decided to go with a cut on contact broadhead because I'm not losing any energy compared to an expandable. Also, these broadheads are razor sharp, and I like the fact that I can sharpen them myself to make sure they're as sharp as they possibly can be. In the past, I've used expandables, and not once had I had a single pass through on a deer, but with this setup and this broadhead, I've passed through every single time, and that alone makes me feel super confident in a fixed blade broadhead. Well, that's a wrap of my arrow setup. I know this video was short and sweet, but I just want to give an overview of what I shoot with my low poundage arrows. And for reference again, I do shoot 50 pounds and I have a 26 inch draw length, but I'd like to know your arrow setups in the comments, so make sure you drop that below. If you found this video useful, please drop me a like and also subscribe. If you have any questions, leave those in the comments also, or hit me up on Instagram and here is my handle. But thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.